Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? I have hired the Mengele Garant 540/2, and I've also got the additive and the blades, so we'll get to that in just a second. My question for this week is, I am considering using the GPS mod. It's quite well known, and what it does is it sets the precise distance up through the field for whatever machine that you're using, and then will, once you start driving up through the field and you engage GPS, it steers for you up across the fields. It's quite a handy tool, especially be handy for doing the contracting jobs. If you would like me to use it, let me know. If you would rather I didn't use it, let me know as well. It's your vote, it's your game. Head to the comment section down below and tell me what you think. Right then, I have leased this one, and these two pallets here, these were also available for lease, which is the additive and the blades, rather than having to buy them, which is fantastic news, because if you remember, the... Oh, and to pay for them, I increased my loan by 25,000, so it's now at 150,000 on the loan. So yeah, we got the additive and the blades, and they are quite expensive, but we did have the option to lease them. And I'm sort of going by the assumption that we would be leasing the tank and paying a small amount for them to deliver the additive, and then we pay for the additive itself. So I don't really know how it works. I've never used this before. I've been told if you put the additive in, it increases the yield of the crop. And then the blades, you need to use them if they break. So we might have to get the stayer and put the front loader on and come up and collect these items. I'm not quite sure yet. So, right. Silage additive fill level, 0 litres. Use of blades, 0%. Act load. Oh, actual load, I'm guessing that is. So let's press F1 and see what options we got. Turn on, remove top rope. Remove top ropes. Why would we want to do that? Install top ropes. I'm assuming that that's so that a forager can blow into the top. At least that's what I think it is. So what else have we got? We got exit vehicle toggle. Right, so it doesn't actually say anything else. Turn on the forage wagon. How do we get the additive into the machine? Do I need to come close to the front? Right, there's no option for that. I want to put the additive in. How do I do that? Well, let's just try... What does Y do? Y is removing the top ropes. R for refill. Right, it doesn't refill with R. It might be that we need to pick up that pallet. I'm going to go and get the stayer with the... let me just get rid of that. I'm going to go and fetch the stayer a minute with the front loader, and we will see what we can do. Right, with the tank here, we have a tap on that side. I don't know if that's anything to do with it. And I'm assuming that we've got to put the additive up there. So if we just get this one and lift that tank up, we might then have an option for doing some filling or something. So let's keep the suggested help up there so that we can see if any different options come up. And if I come in through there, pick that one up. Now, what's it going to do? Let's go around to this side so that we can see what it's doing. It's saying that it's empty. I'm not sure if this is a good thing or a bad thing. It might be that we've got to buy the additive. Is that what it is? I did have a big sort of glitch when I was driving over, and I'm hoping it's not this mod doing something weird. Let's go over to here, start up, and... Right, you don't have any option. Right, this is a little confusing. We're supposed to put additive in. Maybe it's got to be put over the top. Let's go up towards the blades. Right, the blades don't do anything. I've got an R. I think we might just have to use this as a regular one. Unless we've got to buy the additive. I know that I leased this one. It cost me 300 to lease it. It might be that I'm supposed to buy the additive. That's the only thing that I can think of now that... because the pallet doesn't contain anything. And the physics, the mechanics of the pallets is you lift them up over and they remove top ropes. Still not doing anything. If I press R now, does it do it? Nope. Let's back up a bit. Right, I've got no clue with this. Okay, we've messed around with this long enough. I will just try buying a pallet and test that, and then I'll take this back over, but I won't subject you to that painful slowness. Okay, I precariously balanced the blades up on top of the additive. The bought tank didn't seem to make any difference whatsoever to it, and if I just set that down a second, I did notice that when you walk beside the additive tank, you do get, if you have that one up, see, it says silage additives fill level 1,000 litres, blades left 140. But beyond that, I haven't been able to get do anything. I have no clue what it's supposed to do or not supposed to do. So we're just going to use this as a regular one. If you have the ropes off, I'm assuming that you can put in from a forage harvester, because if you try to start it up, it says you've got to install the top rope. So we put the top ropes on and we'll start it up. Lower the pickup. I love that sound. That was fantastic. It does make it sound like an old machine. That's pretty cool. Okay, I'm impressed with that. I'm pleased with that. So let's just see what it does now. So actual load. So that tells us how fast we can go, I'm assuming, rather than the actual load in the machine. It doesn't have anything else there. Use of blades, 0.2%. But it's not saying anything about the additive level. Now that is the bit that I'm a little bit, you know, curious about, because that's kind of the crucial part of this whole operation, is we wanted to have the additives, because apparently it gives you, is it more capacity or something? So we do have spare blades. We can go and get blades if we need them. Maybe we got to fill up the machine and then we have to go and use the additive afterwards, sort of add it afterwards. You wouldn't normally do that in real life. In real life, you would run the machine. You'd put additive into that little tank on the side there, which is why I've been really confused. I cannot understand. I tried it with the bought pallet. That made no difference whatsoever. So I returned that one. I did have a slight loss on it, but not as much as I thought I would get. So it's not all bad. We do have some things to be grateful for. Going all over the place here. I'm trying to drive sideways so that you can at least see what I'm doing. And the sunset on the machine does look pretty good. So there we go. There's our sunset on a machine. Looking fan-schmabulous. So there is the Mengele Garant in all its glory, running at 35% load. I'm assuming that if we'd used a rake and raked all of this up first, because the swath would be that much heavier, it would push the load capacity on the machine. Right, let's actually, no, I'm just going to keep going now until we've filled it up, and then we can have a look at the silage additive thing again. The blades, we are at 0.28%, so it does look like you can do quite a few blades, do quite a few litres to get quite a lot of silage done before you've got to be changing blades, which is kind of good. You wouldn't want to be spending $4,500 on blades every other load. I like the sound of this thing. It's got a really nice feel to it. It does feel like an older machine, not like the new ones. I've seen brand new machines driving around, and they look pretty impressive. They really do look impressive. These old machines like this, we actually used to have one when I was growing up. When I was very young, I was up until I was 6 years old. I was on a dairy farm, and then my parents sold the farm, and yeah, long story. But anyway, when we were there, we couldn't... Look, the load is going up 100%. Does that mean it's leaving bits behind, or is it not cutting it properly, or what? What's the situation there? Do we lose some of the load? Because obviously here, yeah, as that's going actual load 100%, I don't really know on that. It'd be something we'd have to look into at a later date, I guess. Because we're going to keep this one for a while, we should be able to experiment with it a little bit at other times. Maybe we can try it with a swather and then see what happens when it's running at 100%. That could be interesting. But yeah, anyway, my parents, they weren't able to use a trailed forager because where they were was so windy that it would literally blow it sideways and it wouldn't go into the trailer properly. So way too much waste, it was a serious issue. So they bought two of these. I don't think they were Mengele Garant. I can't remember what sort they were, to be honest. I do remember that one was red and one was green. Red and white and green and white. I do remember that much. That's about all I remember them. I was very young at the time. But they apparently did all of their silage with those for a couple of years, or several years actually, and they were very, very pleased with them. They had no problems with them whatsoever. So I am sort of reenacting my childhood here by using one of these. Right, our load now is coming up at 70-80% each time. I can't remember how full this thing gets before he stops. Right, so we don't get it bleeping at us. So now we want to see if we... So it's 25,195 at the moment. And we're going to go over by the additive and see what the additive does. Use of blades is at 0.78%. So you do get to have... Well, going by that, it's 100 loads before you've got to change any blades over, which is pretty good, I'd say. That's a pretty sweet offer. I think we'll move the blades back so that we don't accidentally do anything with those, because we'll put those on the other side. I want to just concentrate on seeing if we can do anything with this additive, because I thought that it was supposed to increase your capacity. And if you press P and you go, so you got that one there. We'll have a look at the capacity in a second. What am I looking for? Loading wagons. Come through here. This one, it says 25,195. But then I thought that additive was supposed to add, it'd give you extra capacity. So let's pick up these blades. And easy does it. A bit difficult to take them off the top here. I was quite impressed that they actually stayed on there in the journey over. They were wobbling around a little bit, but still, there we go. Right, let's put those down there. And we had 0.8%, I think, in the end on the blades. So, release the pallet. There we go. Okay, that one can stop right there. Let's see what the blades are saying. They are still saying 140 blades. And we're saying over here with the silage additive, this is still saying 1,000 litres. But when we get in here, it's saying silage additive's fill level is zero. So what... do we get any option now? We come near it? No. Right, so there's no... start filling silage additives. Look. Right, what does that do? This is the thing that we need to find out now. So what's it doing? What are we doing here exactly? I really don't know. 10 litres. It's taking a long time. I do know that much. Right. I'm just going to wait for this one to fill up a minute. Okay, that's filled up. We've got 50 litres in there. And if you come down here, this is saying 950 litres left. I haven't seen any money change hands for that, so I'm not really sure what the silage additives are for now. Unless, the only thing that I can think of is either it had to be full before we could put the silage additives in, or we were on the wrong side of the pallet. It might have been that we needed to be on the side with the tap. I only just thought of that because I didn't notice the tap there, but wasn't it already facing the tap? I really don't know. Huh. That's a bit of an odd one. Right, so we know that we got 25,195, so obviously the next thing that we can do, because the reason for the additive was supposed to be that it adds more capacity or it increases the volume or something. It's like an incentive to actually do it. So we will, when we get up here, we can drive into the clap. We'll see how much we got in there, and then we'll empty out and see if that's made a difference. So we've got our clamp here, looking good. Got loads of silage in here now. So how much have we got? We have 102,000 litres of chaff, and I'm stuck. So 102,634. So we should end up with 127,78. About 127,800, roughly. Okay, that's roughly what we should get. So let's start opening it out and see if it does. So silage additives, we haven't used any up. It might be that we didn't actually add it. It's very slow emptying, isn't it? It's much slower emptying this than it is the normal one. Well, that's actually not too bad. It means that you've got a more controlled release and where you want to put it, rather than it all sort of hoofing out into a great big heap on the floor, and then you've got to try desperately to try drive your tractor over the top of it, when it is really just not wanting to happen. So the silage additives haven't changed at all. I'm starting to suspect that it ended up being we needed to be on the right side of the pallet. I think that maybe we weren't facing the pallet correctly or something like that. Shut that down. 127.825. Hmm. That's interesting. Right, well, now that we got the silage additives, we know which way that we were facing when we were up against that pallet, so maybe it's something to do with that. I really don't know. This is a complete and utter mystery to me, because we were parked next to the pallet and it didn't work. It might, maybe we were slightly in the wrong position for the trailer. I don't know. Right, let's get another load and we can take it from there. Maybe we can get to the bottom of this mystery of the silage additives. Right, I'm just going to go straight in here and start up, lower down. Let's get going. We need to get this done because we want to get... Right, are there any other options now that we've got the additive in there? Is that... Oh, turn on silage additives. Z. Right. So I've pressed Z. It's using the silage additives. Is it filling it faster now? Maybe that's what it's doing. Turn it off. I think it does. I think it fills it faster. If you put the silage additive on, it seems to increase the rate at which it fills from... So as it comes into the pickup, it slightly increases the capacity. I think that's what we're doing. That's actually pretty cool. So why couldn't we fill it up before? Okay, we're going to have to... we'll go up to the pallet in a minute. I'm going to fill this one up now, and then we'll go up to the pallet in a minute and we'll see if it makes any difference. If it's just... It's not increasing what's actually in the machine, but it is increasing what we've got coming into the machine. So it basically increases the volume of the windrow as it changes from the windrow to the trailer. I think that's how it's working. And... So what we'll end up with a little bit extra coming off of this field than we would if we didn't use the additive. The blades don't seem to be using up any faster because of it, so that's a good thing. But it is starting to get later in the day. I would like to try and finish this before night. I don't really want to go through the night without having finished and sheeted and rolled the clamp and rolled and then sheeted the clamp. And got it all ready so that then tomorrow we should get silage and we can start thinking about selling it. I'm actually thinking about using conveyor belts. I set up a system of conveyor belts and then put it in like that because, we'll either have to do that or... Ooh, actual load's going all the way up to 100% there. I don't know if that makes any difference to anything. Either we'll use conveyor belts or we will lease the Manitou that everybody wanted. And, It was only marginally more people chose the Manitou than wanted the New Holland. Several people apologised to me for picking the New Holland over the Manitou because I said that that was my favourite. But they wanted to see the New Holland because it was new. We will have to use the Manitou. I appreciate that a lot of you wanted the New Holland, so I'll probably stick that one into my time-lapse series so that everybody gets a taste of New Hollandness, if that's what you wanted. And right now we're completely full. Silage additive fill level is at 43 liters, so we haven't used very much silage additive either. I know that we've only leased the pallet, and I suppose really that's not actually realistic because we don't seem to be having an expense for filling up from it or anything. I'm not really sure about that. I would say maybe the lease price comes with turn off silage additive. So if I turn it off a minute, I don't have an option to refill. Uh, Because I did have an option to refill, didn't I? Let's just turn on. I suppose it's because we've already got some in there. Might be. I'm not sure. It seems to be a bit of a temperamental beast. Now, I am... Well, we'll carry on working our way through this. We sort of know how to do it now. And I'm assuming that that is how it's working, that we're getting... it's increasing the volume of the windrow as it's coming into the machine, is how the additive is working. So, yes, anyway, I'm going to use the Manitou and a bucket, I think. We will lease the Manitou and we'll get a bucket as well, so that'll be another big lease machine. And we'll get that one and we'll use that to spoon some of the silage from the clamp into the BGA thing. However, we have a slight issue with that, in that the bucket for the Manitou, or for the telehandlers, isn't all that big. And I got a feeling that we may regret such a decision, because if you take a look here, where are we? No, I don't want to go there. I want to go there like that, and I want to go to telehandlers. Right, shovel, 4,500 litres. That's nice and all, but so far we have 127,000 litres of silage in here, and it's only set to increase. Right, if I turn on the additive again, let's bring that one up, turn on silage additives, is it going to increase my total yield in here? It is not adding more additive to it, so I don't think it is. We'll see. We'll come back to that. Right, I'll empty this out and I'll get back over to the field. Well, I'm just coming along quite nicely, calmly, minding my own business, when I thought, you know, I haven't actually tried this from in cab yet, so we'll see what it's like. It scared me. I've got to be honest. I was a little frightened. And this is why. See? I was not expecting that at all. What a racket. There's no need for that. Absolute racket, that is. So, yeah. I love this thing. I really do love this thing. It seems to be a lot slower than the other one. The Pottinger, I'm pretty sure the Pottinger runs at like 14 miles an hour. Might be 12, but I'm certain it runs faster than 10. This is as fast as this one will go. You can press 1 to... you should be able to. Yeah, you can press 1 and reduce down your work speed like that. And then all the way back up again. And I can go all the way up to maximum, but 10 miles an hour is as fast as the machine will allow your tractor to drive. So 10 miles an hour is it. We are running... Load capacity at 90% there. Blades on 2%. Silage additive at 39 litres. So we're doing well. I am quite pleased with this machine. It's slow. It's noisy. It's a bit of a nuisance to use. And various other little things like that. But, you know, overall it's not too bad. As for our Manitou, if we use a 4,500 litre bucket... and we want to empty out that silage clamp, we're over 150,000 litres of silage in there now, and by the time we finish this field, we're going to be over 200,000 litres. 200,000 litres is going to be at least 40 bucketfuls, which is going to take a little while to try and get through, so I am seriously tempted to get conveyor belts. And conveyor belts aren't actually that expensive. You need a pickup one, and you need a... you need an end piece, but because of the distance, we'd have to use we'd probably have to use two or three middle pieces as well. So we would be looking at least 30 grand's worth of conveyors if we were to buy them, or however much to lease them. And obviously we're trying to be like a full contract farm here, where you lease everything. So I think if we could do that, that would be pretty cool. Which means that we would lease the conveyor belts, and the reason that I'd like to do this is because, like I said, I worked for someone who was actually a contract farmer, and everything was leased apart from the two tractors that he owned. And he ran a very successful business. So can we do a full contract farming system in a Farming Simulator? Can we lease everything apart from the fields? And obviously we can't go and work the fields for ourselves. when we don't own them and we don't have a way to rent land. It would be really, really cool if there was a way to rent land, but there isn't, so we'll have to buy the land, but everything else we're going to do leasing, and see if this can work. I'm quite sort of excited about this, is see if we can make it work. So I'm going to try to avoid buying anything on this map from now on. I mean, I did say that before, but I'm sort of, the more I think about it, the more I think this could actually be really, really cool to try and get done. But anyway, I'm running out of time, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to finish doing the silage harvest and get it all into this clamp before next episode. And then next episode, we are going to roll this clamp. We will go and get it. We will lease a leveler for the tractor, and we will level off this clamp and roll it down flat and get it sheeted. And I want to do that before dark. We're probably going to be working in the dark on this one. But if we can do that before nightfall, then come the morning, the silage should be nearly ready for harvesting. For starting to dump into the machine over there. 200,000 litres, possibly more than that by the time we're finished, should give us a pretty good yield, I would think. A good amount of money. I'm not sure how much we'll get, but yeah, we'll see. So my quest, I keep stopping at 4. I did that on Sosnovka, didn't I? I had 4 litres, and that's what messed up the leveller when we were trying to use it. We had a big lot of trouble with that. I don't really know why we're getting 4 stuck in there. We'll deal with that. That can be tipped out somewhere way out of the way so it doesn't bother us. My question for the week is, do you want me to download and install the GPS mod? And I quite like the idea of using the GPS mod. I really like using a lot of different mods in the game anyway, and I did say that I would leave it for a while before I put mods in, but I think it's time to start introducing them. We've had a good look at sort of a few of the machines and everything that are available in vanilla, and we will continue to prioritize vanilla machines, but I think it would be good if we could get some sort of scripted things going that alter the game ever so slightly. It could make it a bit more interesting. So if you'd like me to use the GPS mod, head to the comment section down below. Let me know yes or no. It's your vote. It's your game. I am going to go on and finish all of this silage harvest now. So let me just lower that one and start it up. Carry on down here. I'm going to need to turn the lights on more, I think. It's getting very, very dark now. If you've enjoyed this episode, please head down below and give me a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.